Of course, automobiles have evolved over the years, and so has lubricant. And there's a bit of mystique around minerals versus synthetics and what fits where. So today I want to try and put some clarity around that. So, synthetic oil, mineral oil, what are they? Well, we already know that mineral oil comes out of the ground, out of crude oil. That's well known. And there's kind of six grades or stages to oil production. So at this end is mineral, and right up this end is synthetic. Now, if you process mineral oil enough, you can actually land with a synthetic oil. But most synthetic oil is actually this. It's made on the laboratory bench. That's what the base blend looks like, or the base oil, to which a whole lot of additives are put in there to create the specification of oil that's required. So that's kind of up that end of the spectrum. And of course, in the middle, there is also semi-synthetic oil, which is kind of the best of both worlds. So what does both worlds look like? Well, you might not have a Bugatti like this beautiful old 1927. Can you believe that thing does 210 k's an hour? Old George drives it, no roll cage. George, you are my man, brave guy. So you might not have a car like this, but you might have a 70s, an 80s, a 90s car like we all do, or a second car, and you're a bit perplexed or not sure whether to use synthetic oil or mineral oils. And there's a million bad stories around, and the reason there's bad stories around is because people put the wrong specification of oil in their car. There is nothing wrong with putting synthetic oil in a mineral oil or an old car, provided it's the right specification. Now, what do I mean by that? Well, think about it. Modern engines today, fuel efficient, multi-valve, really tight tolerances. So what they require, or what they work really well with, is synthetic oil. Why? Synthetic oil is typically a lower viscosity, so it's runnier, like water, and it can remain very, very stable at very high temperatures, and it also remains, importantly, very stable on very cold, icy mornings. It maintains that level of viscosity. So that's perfect for that application. Now, an older engine typically has larger tolerances in it. So if you go and put a thin oil, low viscosity oil, in an old type engine, of course it's going to consume that oil, burn it up. There's nothing wrong with the oil. The fact is you put the wrong specification in there. So just like here is a mineral and a synthetic oil in identical specifications. So if your mineral oil car called for one, and you put synthetic in there of the same specification, look at the numbers, you got no problem whatsoever. So I hope that sort of clears it up, and as you would expect, Penrite have got a range from way back when, and any mineral oil application you want to put in, and synthetic oils for the modern era, and any specification of that you find that's synthetic, that fits your spec back here, whack it in there, no problem at all.